Aqualung. It's an epic piece of work by Jethro Tull, and a challenging song, not only for you, but for me as a teacher. How do you get an incredibly complex and detailed song, over 6.5 minutes long, and arrange it for solo guitar voice accompaniment? I've taken on this challenge, and I think I might have it. We'll see. We'll be starting with the intro, but first, let's check our tuning. Now for the intro. Check the tablature if it helps you. We'll start off right now. On the D note, your fifth string, second dot on the neck, that's your fifth fret. So it's your fifth string, fifth fret, it's your D. You'll start with the first note for the phrase. Your next note will be a G, which is third fret, sixth string, or basically first dot. So we're going D, G. You've got your D and your G. Now your third note is going to be an A sharp, which is about three frets up from the G. Here's your G. So one, two, three. Your first three notes are D, G, A sharp. Let's put it together real quick. You hit each note one time. Now your next note is going to be a C. We're going to do it on the fifth string, third fret, which is also, again, where you have the first dot. So, C. Note we're talking about, so we're going to go D, G, A sharp, C. Now after that we have a very easy one. That's a C sharp, which is just one fret up from the C. C sharp is just one fret up from the C. So we're going to go real quick, just to wrap it up, after you hit your C sharp, you go back to the C. What do I mean? Check it out. Sounds kind of like Jaws. Okay, same thing. So, let's put it all together. Again. Now start off slow, okay? You don't have to speed through it. Do it slowly. Rewind the tape. Make sure you get a good look at what I'm doing. And little by little, you'll do it quicker and quicker. Signature lick, one more time. As soon as you finish that phrase, you're going to come in on a D flat 5. What are we doing? First finger on a D flat, which is on your fourth fret, one fret above the first dot. Fifth string. So we've got a D flat. And then on your fourth string, or your D string, we're going to go to the sixth fret and play an A flat. That's the first chord you're doing immediately after the phrase. So, now take that exact same fingering and move it up two frets to the sixth fret. Now you have an E flat 5. Okay? So it's the exact same chord up two frets. Tying it all together. Okay? Your third chord. Using the same positioning you're doing with your hand, we're going to go down here to the F. It's the octave to your F. So you're on your third fret. One, two, three. Putting your finger almost where the first dot is, on your neck. And then you're going to take your third finger and put it on the C, which is pretty much on the second dot on the neck. So your C is on your third string, your G string, fifth fret. F and C. Tying it together again. Great. Got that far. Now using the same positioning you have, don't change your finger position. Move down two frets. That has us at an E flat 5 again, only we're playing it on a different part of the neck because it makes it a little easier for you. E flat 5 to the F 5. Tie it together. Up to the F. Now what you're going to do is you're going to be sliding back and forth between your F5 and your E flat 5. Show you what I mean. You notice how I'm sliding. I'm not changing my fingering. My left hand is exactly the same. I'm only sliding it up and down between the two frets. Now you can also attack it with your right hand if you so choose, like this. There's no right or wrong, it's a matter of preference. Let's put it all together so you can see how it's starting to shape up and sound like the song that you've heard 1,000 times. Okay. At this point, you're almost there. You're about halfway through the verse. God help us. Okay. From your F5, you are going to move up half a step to a G flat 5. So from the F5, you're just moving up half a step. Let's tie those last few parts together. Now you'll notice every now and then I might alternate between my pinky and my third finger. There is no right or wrong. Since you're only playing those two notes on the guitar and no other notes on it, do what you're comfortable with. I tend to alternate. It's a personal thing. You don't have to play it the way I do. You can either use your third finger or your pinky. It's whatever is going to feel easier for you. So, where are we? Beginning of the phrase. Sorry about that. I told you it was going to be tough for both of us. Okay, so we're going. After you're hitting your G flat 5, you're going to go down to